Hello and welcome to this week's assembly. I've come down to the East Suite this week, and you might be able to see behind me here the magnolia which some of you helped to plant earlier in the year and which has now come into flower. Later in the assembly we'll be having a short period of silence as usual. I wonder over the last couple of weeks how many of you have noticed the background sounds, even in an empty school during this period of silence. It would be interesting to hear what silence sounds like where you are. Perhaps some of you could record a silence and we could collate some of those. This is week three of thinking about what we call the Quaker testimonies and how they might speak to us during this period of lockdown. I'm sure I don't need to remind you what they are, but just in case, they are simplicity, peace, integrity, community, equality and sustainability. Today we come to integrity. According to the Old Testament book of Proverbs, whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. So what does walking in integrity actually mean? Integrity is a strange word in some ways. Unlike other nouns, it doesn't have an associated adjective. So for example, somebody who practices deceit is deceitful. Somebody who practices charity is charitable. But somebody who practices integrity is quite simply a person of integrity. The word comes to us from the Latin via the Old French. The Latin word integer means whole, and we get from that the word integer, which means a whole number. You can see this idea of wholeness in related words like integral and integrated. Something that's an integral part of something else can't be separated from it. In the same way, when we have integrity, what we say is perfectly integrated with what we do. It's about integrating how we live privately and publicly. There are no contradictions between what we say our values are and how we behave. We practice what we preach, or as the Quakers would say, we let our lives speak. We're often outraged when people are hypocritical, when they don't practice what they preach. You know that recently the government's chief scientific advisor, Neil Ferguson, had to resign because he broke the rules of lockdown, rules that he had in fact helped to set up. Something similar happened to Scotland's chief medical officer, who visited her second home despite telling others not to do something similar. But before we get too judgmental, we should maybe take the plank out of our own eyes before removing the speck from someone else's. As countless psychology experiments have told us, even some of the most respectable looking people will cheat when they think that nobody else will see them. During a time of lockdown, we have to balance our personal freedoms with consideration for others. Acting with integrity is doing what is right all of the time, even when nobody else is there to see it, or even when it involves personal cost. A story is told of an emperor who had no children of his own. So in order to find a successor, he summoned together all the children of the area and gave them each a seed, telling them to plant it in a pot, tend it and come back in a year with the results. As the months went by, many of the children started to talk about the wonderful plants that they had growing in their pots. But one boy who faithfully watered his seed every day found that it was still barren. And he felt embarrassed when he turned up a year later with the other children and saw some of the magnificent plants that they had brought along with them. When the emperor singled him out, however, and called him forward, he was very fearful. But then the emperor explained to him that all the seeds that he had given out had been boiled and were therefore infertile, and that only one person had had the honesty and courage not to substitute the dead seed for something else, the little boy in front of him. Because of his integrity, he would be the person who would be chosen to succeed the emperor. We could take perhaps a more modern example from an advertising slogan that will be familiar to you from Ronseal, who built up a reputation as a market leader because their products don't let you down. They do exactly what they say on the tin. Maybe we could adopt that as a motto. When others look at us, what they see is what they get. It does exactly what it says in the tin. Let's take this challenge of living in integrity and see how we can put it into action over the course of the next week. I hope that things continue to go well for everyone. Believe it or not, this would have been exam week this week, and I'm sure you're not missing exams too much. But do try to do your best in any tasks or assignments that you're given by your teachers, and try your best to keep up with any work that you're set. Next Monday is a bank holiday, and teachers are going to be meeting together online to share their experiences of teaching and plan for the rest of the term, so you can have a day off. I'm going to post next week's assembly on Tuesday morning instead. We're also going to be having a wellbeing week coming up soon, and we'll send out more details of that in due course. So in the meantime, I hope you enjoy the rest of the week, and I hope that things go well for everyone.